Welcome all students. Last week we have learned some basic properties of rational numbers. Today also we are going to see some properties of rational numbers. The first one is identity property for addition. Please make a note of this identity property for addition. For any rational number, A, there exists unique rational number zero such that 0 plus A is equal to A plus 0. Identity property for addition. For any rational number A, there exists a unique rational number 0 such that 0 plus A is equal to A plus 0. What is that? We will see some example of this. Suppose that A is equal to 3 by 7. That A is equal to 3 by 7. That A is equal to 3 by 7. We have to substitute here. That is 0 plus A is equal to A plus Z. Suppose 0 plus 3 by 7. What is 0 plus 3 by 7? It's nothing but 3 by 7. That is equal to A. And also A plus 0. What is A? 3 by 7 plus 0. What will we get? 3 plus 7 plus 0 is nothing but 3 plus 3 by 7. Therefore, 0 plus A is equal to A is equal to A plus 0. It satisfies the identity property. Rational number satisfies the identity property. Next one is identity property for multiplication. Identity property for multiplication. For any rational number, A, there exists unique rational number. There exists unique rational number 1 such that 1 into A is equal to A is equal to A into 1. For any rational number A, there exists unique rational number 1 such that 1 into A is equal to A into 1. Example. The same example we have taken here, that let A is equal to 3 by 7. What is 1 into A? It's nothing but 1 into 3 by 7. 1 into 3 by 7 is 3 by 7. It's nothing but A. What is A into 1? So, A is 3 by 7 into 1. The answer is 3 by 7. Therefore, 1 into A is equal to A into 1. So, the rational number satisfies the identity property for multiplication. Okay. The next one is additive inverse property. Additive inverse property. Additive inverse property. For any rational number, A, there exists a unique rational number total number minus A such that for any rational number A, there exists a unique rational number minus A such that A plus minus A is equal to minus A plus A equal to 0. A plus minus A is equal to minus A plus A equal to 0. Of this, A is equal to minus 11 by 23. So, what is that? A plus minus A. A is nothing but minus 11 by 23 plus of, already here there is 1 minus, here also 1 minus, so it gets plus, so plus 11 by 23. So minus 11 by 23 plus 11 by 23 is equal to 0. Okay, so what is minus A plus A? So minus of minus 11 by 23 plus minus of 11 by 23. Okay. So, here, minus into minus plus. So, 11 by 23 minus 11 by 23 is nothing but 0. Therefore, A plus minus A is equal to minus A plus A equal to 0. Okay. The next one is multiplicative inverse property. Multiplicative inverse property. So for any rational number A, for any rational number A, there exists, for any rational number A, there exists a unique rational number one by A, unique rational number one by A, such that A into 1 by A into 1 by A is equal to 1 by A into A is equal to 1. For any rational number A, there exists a unique rational number 1 by A such that A into 1 by A is equal to 1 by A into A is equal to 1. So first we find out the answer of this property. A into 1 by A is equal to 1 by A into A is equal to 1. Let's take A is equal to minus 11 by 23. So A into 1 by A. What is A into 1 by A? A is minus 11 by 23 into 1 by minus 11 by 23. The next step is 23 goes in the numerator. So 23 into minus 11. Minus minus cancel and also 11 11 cancel, 23 23 cancel, the answer is 1. Next, 1 by A into A. 1 by A is nothing but 1 by minus 11 by 23 into minus 11 by 23. Again, this 23 goes in the numerator. So, 23 by minus 11 into minus 11 by 23. Minus minus cancel, 11 11 cancel, 23 23 cancel. So the answer is 1. So therefore, A into 1 by A is equal to 1 by A into A is equal to 1. Okay, it satisfies the multiplicative inverse property. Okay, the next one is the last property, that is distributive property. Distributive property. So for any rational number, here there are three rational numbers, that is A, B, C. For any rational numbers A, B, C, that distributive law is A into B plus C is equal to A into B into A plus A into C. A into B plus A into C. Distributive property for any rational numbers A, B, C, the distributive law is A into B plus C is equal to A into B plus A into C. If we find out the distributive property, that is A cross B plus C is equal to A cross B plus A cross C. Let me see the example of this. A is equal to 2 by 3. Okay. B is equal to 5 by 6. C is equal to 9 by 6. Example, A is equal to 2 by 3. B is equal to 5 by 6. C is equal to 9 by 6. Okay. First we find out the left hand side. That is this side. A cross B plus C. A into B plus C. First we find out the answer for the bracket. So B plus C. What is B? 5 by 6 plus what is C? 9 by 6. Here the denominators are same. So we write as it is 6. 9 plus 5 is nothing but 14. Okay. So if you want to cancel this means you can cancel this. 7 2s are 14. 3 2s are 6. So the answer is 7 by 3. Then A cross B plus C. A cross B plus C. What is the value of A? 2 by 3. Value of B plus C is 7 by 3. So 2 sevens are 14. 3 threes are 9. 2 sevens are 14. 3 threes are 9. Then we find out the right hand side. What is in right hand side? A cross B. What is A ma? A is nothing but 2 by 3. What is B? 5 by 6. Okay. So 1 2s are 2. 3 2s are 6. So the answer is 5 by 9. 1 5 is a 5. 3 3 is a 9. What is A cross C? That is A into B. What is A into B? A is 2 by 3. And B, C is 9 by 6. 9 by 6. 1 2s are 2. 3 2s are 6. 1 3 is a 3. 3 3 is a 9. This 3 and 3 cancel. So, all are cancelled. The answer is 1. Okay. Then, we have to add this A into B and A into C. A into B plus A into C. What is A into B? It's nothing but 5 by 9. What is A into C? Plus 1. Here the denominators are not same. Okay. Let me consider this as 1. What is the LCM of this 9 and 1? 9. So, 5 plus here 9. So, the answer is 14 by 9. 14 by 9. So, both the answers are both the LHS and also RHS is equal. So, it satisfies the distributive law. Okay. Okay. Let me see the exercise. Exercise 1.3. First one, verify closure property for addition and multiplication of two rational numbers minus 5 by 7 and 8 by 9. Verify closure property that we have already learned in the last week, that is closure property. What is the closure property? Closure property is A plus B and A cross B. That is A into B. A plus B and A into B. This is the closure property. Okay. So, first we find out A plus B. What is A? Let me consider A as minus 5 by 7 and B as 8 by 9. A as minus 5 by 7 and B as 8 by 9. We substitute here. What is A? Minus 5 by 7 plus B 8 by 9. Okay. Here, the denominators are not same because 7 and 9 are different. What is the LCM here? Both are different numbers. We can't take the common divisor. So 7 9s are 63. So minus 5 into 9 plus 8 into 7. 8 into 7. Minus 5 into 9 plus 8 into 7. What is minus 5 into 9? Is nothing but minus 45 plus 8 sevens are 56. So 56 by 63. What is 656 minus 40? 56 minus 45. The answer is 11. Isn't it, ma? 6 minus 5 is 1. 5 minus 4 is 1. So the answer is 11 by 63. Therefore, A plus B is equal to 11 by 63. Okay. Next, we find out A into B. What is A? Minus 5 by 7. What is B? 8 by 9. Okay. So here, the denominator 9 sevens are 63. Minus 5 into 8 is answer minus 40. So answer is minus 40 by 63. This is the value of A into B. Okay. So the second sum. Verify the commutative property for addition and multiplication for the rational numbers minus 10 by 11 and minus 8 by 33. Here the value of A is minus 10 by 11 and B as minus 8 by 33. Can you remember that commutative property? That is A plus B is equal to B plus A. The second one, multiplication is A into B is equal to B into A. Okay. So if we find out the first property, the addition property. Okay. So A plus B. What is A plus B? Minus 10 by 11 plus minus 8 by 33. Here the denominators are not same. Isn't it? So take the LCM. 11, 33. How many 11 times? 1 11 are 11. 3 11 are. So the answer is 33. So minus 10 into 3 plus minus 8 into 1. So minus 8, 10 into 3 is minus 30 plus into minus minus 8 by 33. So the answer is minus 38 by 33. Minus 38 by 33. We have to check it the next side, that is B plus C also. Okay. So B plus C. What is B? Minus 8 by 33 plus minus 10 by 11. Here also the denominators are not same. Take the same as an LCM, 33. So minus 8 into 1 plus minus 10 into 3. So again, minus 8 into 1 is minus 8. Minus 10 into 3 is 30 by 33. So the answer is minus 38 by 33. So A plus B and as well as B plus A, both are same value. So it satisfies the first property, that is addition, commutative property for addition. It satisfies. Okay. The next one is multiplication. That is A cross B. A cross B. What is A? That is minus 10 by 11. What is B? Minus 8 by 33. Okay. Minus 10 by 11 into minus 8 by 33. So here, 11 into 33 is nothing but 363. Then minus into minus plus 10 8s are 80. So the next one is B into A. Minus 8 by 33 into minus 10 by 11. So 33 into 11 is nothing but 363. Then minus into minus plus 8 tens are 80. Here also A into B and B into A has same value, 80 by 363. So it satisfies the commutative property for multiplication also. Okay. So we have the end portion now. We will continue the next sums in the next coming week. We will continue the same exercise. Okay. Thank you, children.